I have to walk at night and be with many and give myself to many strangers. I don't know why. I only know that people smile sometimes, and I must smile back. A certain eye, a smile, the way somebody walks. I need mostly love. Everything else must find its place. I need the warm touch, the unfamiliar smile, the umbrella when it rains, the head against the shoulder when the thunder comes, the unfamiliar touch, the knowing that somebody loves me, even for a little while. You'll like my house. The music's okay. The lights are nice. And I'm warm, you'll see. Can you still go home with me knowing the way I am in mourning? Might make you sorry that you did. I mean, it's different for me in the mornings. I'm not afraid of yellow sunlight or suspicious of rooms without music and atmosphere, but things work best for me after 5 o'clock. It's been like this always. And you must believe I'll be good to you for me to work the best. I will, you know. I will try so hard, for it has been so long since I have had a woman or a special friend. So turn the corner with me. Stay close. Don't be afraid, for there is no one else but me. And I am warm. You'll see. Be gentle with me, new love. Treat me tenderly. I need the gentle touch, the hand, the soft voice, the candlelight after 9. There have been so many who didn't understand. So give me all the love I see in your timid eyes. But give it gently, please. What could I say after it was done? What could I say to you, crouched in a little heap, crying, as though the only thing you had to give away was gone now? There are no words, but it was love. What could I say? You were smiling before, but passion chases even smiles away. And even when it's done, even afterward, lovers are as far apart as they were before. Nothing's ever settled by the act. You go to sleep in your own private little world, and I drift off to mine. Only the passion eased, only the moment filled. It's as though there was something way off beyond that nobody even knows about yet. To turn off the light. I remember nothing more of that moment. Only awakening in the middle of the night do I remember well, and finding my head in the small arc of your back, and feeling the warmness of you swell upon my forehead, lying very still and warm, praying that morning might be late, just this once late. Suddenly, I cannot remember the color of your eyes, or the things we said as we stood together for the last time. Suddenly my mind is blurred. Trees are not important anymore. They are only trees. Birds and butterflies dart down canyons between tall buildings, looking for a place to hide. As the sky above the city darkens and the rain begins, it's timid at first, unsure, then creeping onto window ledges and foraging along the sidewalk. They're tearing down the building across the street, and the old woman who sat cushion high behind the flower boxes is gone. Even the children who played hopscotch along the broken sidewalk have disappeared. Only the multicolored cat preening in the shop window is unconcerned as night begins. Night now. After an even longer day than yesterday, there is a fog and a little rain. I suppose the long, slow summer is gone. The warm time is over. Just as well, I guess. All the days can't be shining bright. All the nights something to remember. I'm sorry we quarreled. I always feel ashamed afterward. I always need you most when we've quarreled. But think about the good times if you can. Don't walk in the rain anymore tonight. Alone in the busy station, I waited, but you never arrived. People came and went. Little family pageants were enacted over and over again, but you never came. I watched the wall clock, picked out the dispatcher's every scrambled word. I waited, and the hour grew late. Still no you. And so, very weary, I left the station and went home. Only a day away, and the loneliness is unbearable. How will it be if you're a year gone? What will happen if I'm not to know again your warm arms, your shoulder next to my face at night, the quiet talk over strong coffee, the chase along the tolled beach, waking up in the morning, and oh God, so many things. I'm afraid of being alone anymore. It happens every time you close the door or go into the next room away from me or turn your back on me even a little. I am like a child again. I can't be left alone. Hurry, hurry, hurry. I stood watching as you crossed the street for the last time, trying hard to memorize you, knowing it would be important. The way you walked, the way you looked back over your shoulder at me. Finally, you reached the other side of the street, put your bag down and leaned against the wall, and began watching me as I walked up the street toward the station. And then the long ride home. Oh God, it was long. Because I was so very much alone. And the others on the train were kind, as people always are on trains. They offered me magazines when I needed you. They asked the time when I didn't even know what day it was. Across the way there was a girl crying, long silent tears, while an old man held her hand. Sometimes I think I will never ride a train again. Thank you. by myself today in the park, with pigeons gargling in the grass, and old men reading newspapers, and children everywhere. I thought about your homecoming, a lifetime planned, a hope for better things, an alliance. Times when you were here, or I was waiting for you, expecting your step or whistle on the stair. But I was sure my whole world was this brass bed, and this ceiling, and these four walls. And I have been content with that world. But now, with you away, not next to me, breathing and sleeping and loving me, there is no world large enough to lose my unhappiness, to forget how wide and empty a brass bed can be. Alone again this Sunday morning, I awaken to children quarreling in alleyways, accompanied by taxi horns and people I can hear but not see. The dingy sunlight highlights dirty window panes, and there is a dull thumping in the back of my head somewhere that won't let me cry. What did I do? Did I love you like the others? Did I love you too little or too strong? Did my eyes turn out to be not as tender as you thought they were at first? There must have been a moment when you stopped caring. But I don't know when. I only know this brass bed world is very lonely now. Waves pound along the rocks. Children with pails gather water, splashing it on the rebelling sand. A little girl fashions a necklace from shells. The great bodies of men and women move together for love. A walrus dives, reconsiders and dives again. Only the shadow of a passing train sees it all, mirrors it in smoke and rumbling and passes on. His hair is black. He stands 20 summers tall, and the prints he leaves on the sand as he runs along the beach send our hearts singing. He is like me. We are brothers, though we haven't met. He runs because the bird does not sing sweetly when he's caged. He runs because she smiled too often, or did not understand, when being alone sometimes was all he asked. Midsummer is not the only reason I'm going home. To the yellow corn and the grasshopper playing in the tall grass, and the indolent butterfly darting from marigold to rose and back again. I'm going back again to meet the dreaded winter, and the unsure spring, and the girl whose eyes never met mine when we swam together in the river and made love below the old brick bridge. I'm going home to see if there really is such a place as home. It takes a long time for a single blossom to fall from a flower tree, and I have so much time to spare that I can watch all the flowers fall from all the trees. Face down in the tall grass you lie. There is no wind. The hummingbird goes by without seeing. The sun is almost down. You breathe lightly now. Your dress fans out behind you, and the earth is moist where you lie. Moments ago, the ducks played on the mill pond, and the sparrows chatted freely, and the chickens poked and pecked about the yard, and the killdeer birds flew west beyond the olive grove, and the sun was high, and the wind was electric. But with the loss of tension, you lie in the tall grass, propped up on one elbow now, smiling at me. Our heads lightly touching, our bodies each to each, the sky our only audience, and love somewhere between us, lost in the tall grass. And each moment lost will not come back, and never again will the same dying sun look over its shoulder at us in the same way. The first time is the hardest, but also the warmest and the closest. And yes, the best. Everywhere Oak Harbor is awakening to spring. The hills flower green and dark green. The sky promises April. And the killdeer birds, always last to notice spring, begin their early march across the meadow. Today I left the island. The ferry boat muscled away from the beach for the last time. And I started my journey home, imagining you still looking at Mount Baker from your second-story window, or polishing your skis, contemplating Colorado. It had been sudden and worthwhile, the bright island dreamed of, but seldom found. Rainy time has come again. The meadow has become a swamp, and the cattle huddle together under a leaky barn. The milk boy hurries with his pails toward the warm, dry kitchen, and the killdeer birds fly over the meadow and out of sight. On seeing the birds, I cry, "Look!" And remember suddenly, you're not here. A calf cries out and a mother answers, and all at once the sky is gone. Island life was the best. Sundays at Whitby. You sketching sunlight in the tall mountains, scrambled eggs and pictures at an exhibition. Spring came late to Oak Harbor. On Saturday night, I'd go to your room and wait, anticipating breakfast. Those runaway weekends when we became each other. So now it's time to go. And I remember Oak Harbor, Cranberry Lake, Deception Pass, Whitby, rural towns where rural children march off each morning to rural schools. So I go. I'm in a strange town tonight. Nobody knows me here. There are no old images I have to live up to. No old promises I have to keep. Nobody expects anything of me. I can disappoint no one. Slowly the moon reaches out beyond the buildings. It's Saturday night. The lone dog loiters in the street. Slowly the moon, past the girls with whiskey-colored hair, past the men with downcast eyes, and the lovers everywhere. The cafes play no music. The street is quiet. The moon moves on. I need love now. You know, Saturday night is better than Friday. If you don't make out, you can take home the Great American Consolation Prize. 30 cents worth of love. The Sunday paper. The lovers hurry home now to shut their doors, and you and I are left alone. The policeman walks on through the fog, pacing, unaware, endlessly pacing. A star is falling. Everybody's star is falling. Things are hazy. Clouds make patterns on the ocean. We will go home too. And finally, with the liquor gone, the need for sleep forgotten, we will move together to forget the cruel suburban heat. A star falls, and the world is black and white again. There is no turning back now. We've reached a time when people need each other. People have to talk, and maybe their bodies say it best. We've reached the time of Eros, when love is the question and the answer. Brandy can no longer warm the heart, and words are too indelible to mean anything anymore. A touch says it all. Body does it. As leaves blow along the beach and the bleached starfish are washed upon the shore, I wait, anticipating nothing, watching seasons come and go, not pretending anymore or daring to imagine, uncertain even of spring, I wait. I put a seashell to my ear, and it all comes back. The Mediterranean blue, the yellow sun, the children running on the beach that day, the wind's soft murmur in the rocks, and you. I wanted you that day at the beach because you were beautiful, and because you smiled, and because I knew I would be good for you. I wanted you because my arms were aching for the touch of something warm, something remembered. But you never looked up. The heart is like everything else, I guess. It has its season. It has its time. I wait now, at the beach or walking by the river or looking up beyond the bridges at the sky. I wait and listen or put a seashell to my ear. And it all comes back. I want autumn. I want the leaves to start falling, and the slow rain, and the white moon, and the lighted windows after 8 o'clock. And the smiles of people I've not met yet. And love, all elbows and knees and breasts coming to me in the night. Letting go, then going away. I want kisses that know the whole body geography and love weight and little hands that cover my eyes against the bare walls. The Bach music to still the murmurs and hold the breathing back. To know the wild inside of love again. To find the dark places. I want autumn to come back. You in the dress with a high white collar. I in a rumpled uniform. Having been lonely that night on leave, I wandered into Bobby's and found you sitting on a high stool at the bar in the corner with your shoes off, waiting for someone who didn't show up. I remember your black hair, how you smiled, the laugh you laughed when you wrote your address on a tiny scrap of paper and went down the stairs and away. I still remember the music. And you. But I lost a slip of paper. Warmed over me last night, and I was down by the waters alone, with the foghorn crying like a banshee or a stray lamb. And even though the fog never separated the ocean from the sky, the moon made patterns on the water, exaggerations, promises of things to come. This night I have found a friend. She came to me with eyes deep and eyes rewarding. And all night I will lie in her closeness, happy. Closer. Now we are one. Dig your nails in, it only brings us closer. Tomorrow I'll take you for a boat ride. But relax now. Thank you for kissing me in the elevator last night. Holidays meant little when I was young. The children's games in the afternoon, the late breakfast, the sledding on the cold, bleak hills till supper time. Thank you for the flowers and the snow this morning, and for jam from the delicatessen, and for loving me. Thank you for this one-room world that is all I need when you are here. Today, while lying face to face with love and knowing happiness again, I close my eyes to seasons and disguise, and I was young again, sledding on the cold, bleak hills. Thank you. In the back of the heart, there is always an island, a place kept apart, solitary, away from even friendly people. An island meant to share some time with one. It is populated with friendly music, green things, shells and clippings, and thoughts never ever spoken. It is a real place with balloons that don't break, and kites that always fly, and birds that stay around. I never showed my island to anyone before, but you may see it if you like. In return, I do not ask for much. Now and then a touch, perhaps a friendly word, the sight of your naked eyes invading my private world, the knowing there are secrets we share, and yes, perhaps a little love. Not much at first, but more than you give to strangers. Loneliness is no virgin to me. I have held her hand before, returned her Vinrose smile, and walked with her through mist too thick to see the light of day. Sometimes, even on happy nights, I've called her back to add a sense of balance to the night. Yet if she came just now, I wouldn't recognize her face till many hours had passed and you were far away. I sent you love in long misspelled letters, remember? And you never wrote back. And that spring was hard, because everybody else seemed to have somebody. And now and again, people would tell me about you. Sometimes I'd see you in the street, or looking from a window, or passing by in crowds, the hundred yous that populate this lonesome city. And I'd call after you, your name catching in my throat. And there were others that year, some taller, some with yellow hair, some whose memory still echoes down the corridor outside my room when I try to sleep. But it seldom worked. They were always too intense or too playful or too rehearsed or too anything. And there was always the war of remembering you or forgetting you while in somebody's arms. I don't remember you now, not your eyes or what you said as you stood in the summer doorway and waved me out of your life. I've forgotten you, your hands, your quick little mouth, just as I've forgotten Hampton skies, the athletes and the old school annual, and the songs we sang that summer. I don't remember you, when the sun sinks low and there's no one here to spend the night with me. Remembering is for people whose images have grown dim. You are not remembered. You are real. Though years have put you from me, you are real. I was wrong to invade your little world of museums and kites and pigeons flying. I have deceived you. Not by meeting other strangers' eyes or knowing arms that were not yours, but by pretending to be young at heart and invading your stuffed animal world. I should have stood aside when your kite came sailing down, but I had to run and help. Leaves fall down now. Brown and beautiful, brittle to the touch, lying on the ground or filling public fountains or swirling down the street. 1 year older and still I look. In the park, by the river, on the street, at every face, in every eye. Passing by in trains I see it, in the subways and on the hills, the same face sometimes, walking a little bit ahead of me, and still I look, growing older all the time, opening my eyes in strange hotels, last night's memory clouded, mixed with all the other memories, following neon after 9 o'clock, watching people like a cat sometimes. I'm running out of tomorrows and arms to run to, strange or familiar. It is as though my world now is made only of yesterday's Sunday afternoons, old skies, snow on red brick pavements, and passers-by remembered. But maybe tomorrow. It has been so long since I have lain in the closeness of someone's arms, sheltered throughout the night, belonging. Another year comes, only a few weeks now till another year. Sometimes I yearn for the old life back in San Francisco, the house on McAllister Street. Sometimes I yearn for the old life, the swishing sound cars made along the street when it rained, the city and its people. The 700,000 that never got to know each other. New Year's Eve. Confetti, balloons, masks, little horns, and the lonely ones. New Year's Eve. 12 peeled out, and throngs kissed on Market Street. But no one resembled you. Tune again, the same one, now loud, now soft, now far away, now ringing in my head as though it will never go, that same tune in this same room. Nothing has changed, everything is still the same. See, I'll take your hand pretending you're still here. I'll look at you and smile a smile you like best in all the world. We'll walk for a while, maybe to the foot of the hill to buy magazines and a Sunday paper and English marmalade for breakfast, then hurry off to bed. And when the clock in the nearby church tower sounds some early hour, we'll fall asleep after love. I know it all so well that pretending will be easy. And there is that tune, that same song we knew, playing over and over again, everywhere. Help me remember. When I think of love, I think of Lion's Room, where everything begins and ends. Songs like lilac wine, and girls I knew beneath the chinaberry trees at home when I was young. Of times I swam naked where the irrigation ditch meets the river. Walking after midnight expecting something, a sudden thing, like making love on a little bed one rich red Sunday when everyone was away at church. Hearing Beretta sing when the world was young, when I'm with someone new. A girl fanning herself under a naked light bulb in a room in Taegu. The skeleton of kites setting off treetops and telephone lines. Wild strawberry blossoms that decorate hills of otherwise green. I think of people dying alone and lying my head in someone's lap and feeling the contour of their legs. Neighborhood bars and taking someone home with me, having a dozen cups of coffee before I dared to touch them. And then the night so short, not minding my arm falling asleep behind her back. Planning the day with someone remembered in mind, as though those eyes were bright for me still, and that head still inclined to mine. When I think of love, I think, what the hell, I've been in love before. I'm not so bad off. Maybe it'll happen again. But nights are long sometimes. I've slept alone so long now, and had breakfast by myself so many times, that maybe it won't happen again. But I have to keep thinking it will. Thank you.